Forged in the sun by Superman and empowered by each member of the Justice League, the Hellbat armor was created with a single goal: to protect and empower Batman in battles against the many powerful villains the League came across. While not necessarily having a huge number of abilities on its own, the suit is easily Batman's most powerful. The suit is powered by a Chaos Shard, a powerful energy source capable of producing small bursts of incredible energy. The suit has cloaking capabilities that make the wearer completely invisible, and the cape can transform into wings, granting Batman flight capabilities. In addition to these abilities, this suit grants Batman a huge boost to his physical strength and speed. Coupled with his mastery of almost every martial art, the Hellbat armor allows Batman to go toe-to-toe with incredibly powerful foes. While this suit makes Batman many times stronger, it does have the potential to kill him if he uses it too often or too long. However, knowing this drawback, the suit was designed to be able to eject various parts, such as the helmet and gauntlets, to slow down the fatigue and drain. The most notable instance of this suit's usage followed a battle against Ra's al Ghul when Batman was forced to watch as the bodies of his son Damian and former lover Talia were stolen and brought to Ra's al Ghul's lair, forcing the Dark Knight to battle the League of Shadow Assassin for his son's body. After a fierce fight, Glorious Godfrey, an agent of Darkseid, stole Damian's sarcophagus along with his body and fled to Darkseid's homeworld of Apocalypse. Knowing that he couldn't fight the powerful god alone, and with the Justice League refusing to leave Earth undefended, Batman prepared the most powerful weapon in his arsenal, the Hellbat armor. After an exchange with Lex Luthor on the Justice League satellite, Batman used a Mother Box, a sentient New God machine, to create a boom tube, or portal, where he found the minions of Darkseid fighting among themselves. He beat down all but one of the group, suspending the survivor in the air by its neck, demanding to know where Godfrey was. After the creature gave him what he needed, Batman smashed in its face and quickly flew in the direction that it pointed in search of his son. After finding Godfrey and brutally leaving Godfrey's minions crippled, Batman turned his attention to the man himself, driving him through a solid stone wall as he demanded the immortal tell him the location of Damian's body. Godfrey surrendered, telling Batman that he gave the boy to Kalibak, one of Darkseid's most trusted underlings, who planned to use him to power a planet-destroying weapon. Upon hearing this, Batman quickly knocked him out and flew towards Kalibak's location. Kalibak received a message from one of his sentries telling him that a single enemy was coming to his location, but he ignored the warning, telling his men to use whatever force they needed to defeat the lone warrior. As Batman approached, he was met with a large battleship, but he easily destroyed it by flying directly through the entire ship, causing a massive explosion. As the Dark Knight looked around, he saw an army of parademons and other minions of Kalibak, and he began to tear through them with ease, at one point taunting them by telling them that it was Batman who would destroy them. After destroying all of the enemies before him, Batman was faced with several members of the Bat family and Cyborg, who told him that they had followed him to Apocalypse to help him retrieve Damian's body. They then went together to confront Kalibak, who was preparing to fire his weapon using Damian's body. After arriving at Kalibak's lair, the Bat family began their search for Damian, and the Dark Knight dueled Darkseid's minion. Kalibak and Batman seemed to fight evenly for a moment, but Batman easily flipped Kalibak over his shoulder and disarmed him, instantly rendering him unconscious with his own Beta Club, a powerful energy weapon that attacks the nervous system. This was no small feat, as Kalibak is also a new god and is actually the son of Darkseid. Upon finding Damian's body, the Dark Knight prepared to leave through his Mother Box, but Cyborg was suddenly attacked by a powerful foe. Batman turned to find himself face to face with the Mad Titan Darkseid himself. Darkseid, having been injured by the Dark Knight previously, said that he was glad to see him, and that the scars from their last encounter strengthened his resolve, to which Batman said that he had traveled a long way to see Darkseid. Responding that Batman had come a long way to die, Darkseid promised death for the wounds inflicted upon him in their last encounter. As Batman rejected his words, he was nearly attacked from behind by Kalibak, who had recovered from his injuries enough to join the fight. But he was quickly removed when Batman used the Mother Box to teleport him to the other side of Apocalypse. As soon as he used it, Darkseid crushed the Mother Box and told the Dark Knight that he couldn't escape, to which Batman said that he wasn't planning to leave just yet, as he landed a solid hit on Darkseid, drawing blood. The two continued to battle, Darkseid taking another punch from Batman before grabbing him by the leg and slamming him into the ground. As Darkseid taunted him, Batman grabbed Damian's body and told Cyborg to open up a boom tube to help him escape. But before he could finish his sentence, Darkseid appeared above him and smashed him into the ground, forcing him to drop his son's body. Standing above him, Darkseid ripped the wings from Batman's back, telling Batman that he knew the Chaos Shard in his armor was killing him. He planted a foot on the Dark Knight's head, asking him why he would risk unimaginable horror at Darkseid's hands. Batman responded by saying that he had already been through such horrors, and the wings that Darkseid had ripped off turned into a swarm of bats and reformed on the suit, the damage undone. Batman landed another powerful blow on the Mad Titan, and was immediately trapped in his grasp as Darkseid began to crush him. Throwing his opponent to the ground once again, Darkseid noticed that Batman's allies managed to open up a boom tube to escape, and he told Batman that they would leave him to die, prompting Batman to tell Darkseid to kill him. Darkseid fired his Omega Beams at the Dark Knight, but failed to notice him holding the Chaos Shard until it absorbed the beams, which had been Batman's true purpose in the battle. Shocked that his beams were ineffective, Darkseid was caught off guard when Batman fired his suit's chest beam, which did enough damage to the god to pin him to the wall and knock him out of the fight for the time being. His objective achieved, Batman and his allies quickly retreated through the portal, just as Kalibak arrived to the scene. He made to follow, but Darkseid told him not to bother, saying that they would see the Earthlings soon enough. Once through the portal, Bruce's body had been badly damaged from using the Hellbat armor, and he was mere minutes from death, but he refused to remove it before bringing Damian back to life. Just as he was about to pass on, he stabbed the Chaos Shard that was empowered with Darkseid's energy into Damian's body, bringing him back to life and reversing the damage done to his own body. As the Hellbat armor crumbled around him, Damian opened his eyes, and father and son were finally reunited.